Hi everyone, I'm Mary with Mary Greeley News. Thank you for joining me. Here's an image taken from still camera photos put together showing Old Faithful yesterday. Yeah, the steam coming up was a little dirty, really windy there, and you can see the snow that came in during the night, how quickly it melted that was on the ground yesterday. Now, according to another document that I found, Yellowstone has been resurging, growing, magma coming into the system for about 3,000 years. Yeah, there's some buffalo moving across the boardwalk and back up over there. This here is an image from about 8 o'clock in the morning yesterday. I wish I had some good news for you. Yesterday, yeah, look how quick that snow starts to melt. Yesterday there was a surge of magma coming into the system at Yellowstone Lake, particularly Little West Thumb. Here we have a spectrogram provided by unavco.org of Yellowstone Lake. This is the surge of magma that I was coming in, that I was talking about. Let me pull it down a little bit so you can see. Yeah, the deeper the color, red being hotter and blue being colder. This here is Grant, the spectrogram they're providing from the strain meter for Grant. And I've talked about Grant. Yeah, look how yellow that went. How Grant is an area where they had an earthquake swarm that the magma was trying to break through the ground at. This area is located by Little West Thumb. This is one of the most recent eruptions there they had at the park. Oh, somewhere between 162 to 150,000 years ago. Down over here we have Grant. Talked about the fault line. You can see the blue line. That's a fault line that runs through here. And I've talked about the fault line there at Yellowstone Lake, where dike intrusion of magma is trying to break through of rhyolite. Over here was me tracking an earthquake swarm that occurred. That was December 7th of last year. Yellowstone Lake on the left, Little West Thumb in the middle, and Madison River here on the right. Look at the activity at Little West Thumb yesterday. This is that time frame right here. There's a lot of them marked in red for Yellowstone Lake. Oh, we got one here. Let me try and find them. What, another one there? I don't know if it's there or what, but there is a lot of them. A little concerning in what was going on yesterday. Borehole 208 for Yellowstone Lake. X is north, Y is east. This here is for the last 7 days going down to the disk. All right, so keep this in mind. The magma is rising. If you look at the ground towards the north is rising up, but the magma under the ground is flowing east. So Yellowstone Lake is east of Grant. Now here's a diagram of the Grant well, borehole 944. It is 500 feet under the ground. Let me pull it down for you. The strain meter is 394 feet, and the seismometer is about 375 feet under the ground. The top has a cap of cement, so it does not pick up any outside noise. No stampeding buffalo, no snowmobiles, cars going over speed bumps. It will not pick it up. All the boreholes there at the park are basically made the same with about the same depth. So here is the data from Grant. Top is north for the last 7 days. See how it took a jump? X is north, Y is east. And look at this. Look at all the dots. For quite a while, the trend of the uplift was on the western side. You can see that. But now it's kind of spreading out. Last 7 days. Last 30 days. Each time the ground goes up and down, it's been taking a breath. That's what I call it. And we got dots way here south. And there's one way over there north. This is for the last 30 days. The tilt meter for the North Geyser Basin area, borehole 205. It suddenly went down in the north, but east is rising. Look at that, how it's breathing. And look at the direction that it's changing. Now remember, Yellowstone Lake is southeast from this location, and it's showing uplift in the southeast. This here is from the last 7 days, and then we'll go to the last 30 days. There we go. This is a trend it was doing before, kind of a southwest. Now all of a sudden it decided it's going to go southeast. See that? Yeah, like I said, it's a little disturbing. Another borehole from the Norris Geyser Basin area, borehole 950. Top is north, bottom is east, last 7 days, and the trend is going southeast, last 30 days. See how it was originally going north? And I've talked about this, and now all of a sudden it's changing. So using Google Earth, we'll go to the Norris Geyser Basin area. There we go, up over there. Kind of northwest of Yellowstone. And this is the uplift that's showing a southeast direction, which is, let me pull it over, Yellowstone Lake. We have uplift at Yellowstone Lake. We have two calderas over here at Yellowstone Lake. We're actually close to it. We have the Sour Creek Resurgent Dome, and we also have the Mallard Lake Resurgent Dome, where the Old Faithful web camera that's supposed to be live and it's not working is located. They know the last time that Yellowstone erupted, it did a counterclockwise unzipping of the caldera coming from northwest, working its way down towards the south, towards Heart Lake, and then both calderas erupted, which caused the collapse and the major eruption the last time of Yellowstone. Here's the monitors for Yellowstone Lake at the top, Little West Thumb, and Maple Creek. Look how thick the magma was coming in at Maple Creek. Now this is what I monitor, what's going on at the Sawtooth Mountain. I'll go ahead about 4 hours. Show you all the activity. I'll pull it over so you can see the time. You can see how Yellowstone Lake and West Thumb have been highly active, how thick the magma is that's coming in there at Sawtooth. And I'm going to show you another paper that I found. Look at all the earthquakes about the Sawtooth and the Snake River Plateau is in fact all related. And we'll go ahead another 2 hours or 4 hours. Look at all those earthquakes. And this is what it's currently showing. Seismicity and earthquake hazard analysis of the Teton-Yellowstone region, Wyoming. They received the article in 2008 and became published in 2009. The earthquake hazard in the Teton-Yellowstone region is the highest in the U.S. Intermountain region. It is not only influenced by lithospheric extension associated with basin range tectonics that extends 700 kilometers west to the Sierra Nevada Mountains, California, but has the superposition of the effect of Yellowstone volcanic sources that can protrude stress up to 50 kilometers from the Yellowstone hotspot track. The effects of Yellowstone hotspot has a profound effect on seismicity, not only on Yellowstone, but on the surrounding fault zones of the Intermountain region. The combined fault zones are part of the parabolic shaped zone of produced earthquake activity surrounding the Yellowstone Snake River Plain volcanic field. The Sawtooth Mountain Range, 50 kilometers from the hotspot track. Let me pull that back over and show you. Hotspot track, 50 kilometers. There's the Sawtooth Mountain Range, and we'll follow it down to the Snake River Plateau. What do we have here? We got the craters of the moon and other volcanic fields. So for 50 kilometers out through this track, where all these past eruptions, we are still having the effect of Yellowstone upon these fault zones. All this information, the documentation, will be down below in the more information box below this video. This paper also has and talks about how the valley floor of Jackson Hole is rising up because of the unprecedented uplift that's going on at Yellowstone and the effect it has upon the Teton Fault Zone, which is drawn out here. Earthquakes of the Teton-Yellowstone region represent a high level of seismicity of the Intermountain West that is associated with interplate extension of the Yellowstone hotspot and the surrounding region, including the Teton and Hedgepin Lake faults. And it mentions the area, and I got Jackson Hole highlighted. The contemporary deformation of the Teton area and its relation to the overall strain field of the Yellowstone region was assessed by GPS observations 2007. The GPS field surveys from 1986 to 2000 indicated the unexpected results, namely that the valley of Jackson Hole is moving upward with respect to the Teton Mountain block, and principal horizontal extension strain axis is generally particular to the fault. This observation implies crustal shortening and compression of the Jackson Hole Valley crust against the fault. But more importantly, the observed westward valley motion from the station closest to the Teton Fault supports the idea that the fault may be locked in compression, which means pressure is building for a large earthquake. Anyway, there was extensive magma coming in from the Snake River Plateau. That's what I got here on the right, showing the thickening of the lines of magma coming in. And I'm going to make this other two monitors larger so you can see the earthquakes. Little West Thumb on the right, Yellowstone Lake on the left. Each line in red indicates an earthquake that the earthquake monitors, the computers picked up, sends a signal for the geologist to come in and review it, trying to find where these are at. Let me close this out and you can, I hope, see them all in red. Okay. This is the one that was the most significant there at West Thumb. We've got another one right there. And we'll go to the signature. See that? Let me go back over here. Anyways, that's all I have for you right now. Sorry, it's not good news. Please put your thoughts, your comments, your questions. I hope you are all prepared for any type of major disaster. We got tornadoes, we got floods, animals being found where they shouldn't be found, earthquakes in diverse locations. Put your questions and comments down below. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you all. Bye.